In this video, we will discuss one story, The Midnight Visitor by Robert Arthur. There are four characters in this story. One is Oshable, another Fowler, Max, and Henry the waiter. Oshable is a secret agent, Fowler is a writer, Max is also a secret agent. But in this story, he is an intruder. And Henry is a waiter, and the writer's name is Robert Arthur. Oshable was a secret agent, but the quality of secret agent was not found in him. Fowler was a writer, and he followed Oshable to collect materials for writing his story. One story on, espionage. But he did not find anything worth what should be collected from his life. He was fat. Oshable was fat, short, and not smart. He did not look smart. He lived in a gloomy French hotel. The street that led to the hotel was musty. He did not have anything that go to make a spy a secret agent. Therefore, Fowler felt let down. He felt dishonored. He felt bored also. But when both of them entered the room, in the room in which Oshable lived, and when the light was switched on, there was a man standing in the middle of the room with a pistol in hand, and it was Max. Max was waiting there in the darkness of the room, and as soon as the light came, as soon as Oshable switched on the light, door opened, switched on the light, they found, both of them, Oshable and Fowler, found Max standing in the middle of the room with a pistol in, automatic pistol in hand. It created panic, it created tense situation, and this was the first authentic thrill of the day for Oshable, for Fowler. Max was trying to snatch away a paper related to missile which could change the course of history, and which was to come to Oshable that night, and Max was there to snatch away the paper. Max had pistol, and on gunpoint he wanted to snatch away the letter, the paper from him, a secret paper. And he entered the room through a pass key, master key. He opened the door of Oshable's room through a pass key, and was there standing. And he admitted that he entered the room through a pass key. But Oshable pretended not to believe him. He cooked a story. Usne ek kahani banai and made Max believe that there was a balcony under the window of his room. There was a window in his room, and he cooked a story and made him believe that there was a balcony under the window of his room. And he also wanted to, lodge a complaint regarding the balcony to the management of the hotel, because through that balcony, several times intruder came into Oshable's room. Therefore, he pretended to be angry, and he told that he would lodge a complaint. He lodged a complaint in the previous year, and he would again lodge the complaint regarding that balcony, to block that balcony so that nobody would enter his room through the window. Anyhow, Max believed it. Max believed that there was a balcony under the window. And in the meantime, someone knocked at the door. Oshable, Max, having a pistol in his hand, scared. He wanted to know who is that. And Osebel told police. And then Osebel asked him what he would do, asked Max what he would do if police comes. If he also told that if Osebel, if he did not open the door, they would break open the door and shoot Max. Max, to save his life, jumped through the window. And you know, in the beginning of the story, I was telling that the room Osebel lived was at the top floor, at the sixth floor of the hotel. And there was no balcony. Max jumped through the window and was no more. He was killed. This way, this story comes to an end. The person who does not look like a secret agent was a real secret agent, Osebel. And Max, the intelligent, smart, slim person who entered the room with pistol in hand, wanted to have the paper related to new missile which could change the history of the world, was entrapped in the false story of Osebel, and believed that there was a balcony under the window. He jumped out and lost his life. This is the story. Thank you. I think you will understand.